Stand there with it. Hey everybody, Steve and Jason, Greenville Academy Martial Arts. Great to be back. Thank you for watching. Hope you're having a great day and you're not like being mauled by a bear or something. That'd be a bad day. But seriously, today's subject, we're talking about focus myths and good footwork and JKD, because people can say good footwork all day long and then they just don't know how to train for it. Because it's not just knowing how to do it, it's being able to do it with aliveness, being able to adjust timing and distance with a real live opponent. We think the best way to get good at this is good focus mitt drills, not necessarily sparring. Sparring's good, but can get a bit too competitive sometimes, and it's really hard to train some of the shots that we like to train, especially that groin kick and the shin knee kick. Those are game changers when you're actually scoring those shots. And so we want to try to keep this as close to the vest as possible with the JKD structure of a good ready position, straight hits, preferably from the lead hand, lead foot, and footwork that moves that ready position. All right, you may have heard me say before that people get confused. They think movement means, you know, they're just out there moving around. That's not the case. Just bouncing around is not good footwork. Good footwork moves to ready position, and the ready position is ready to fire straight shots, preferably from the lead hand, lead foot. Okay, so I'm going to bring in two of my favorite people, and I say that all the time, but I really mean it. All right, so in comes Ethan. I'm gonna introduce you to Ethan first. He's gonna be the mitt holder, and this is Ethan. And here comes Justin. So we'll get him in the middle here too. These guys will be helping us out today and going over this. And they also have their own YouTube channel. And so you guys have to check out that YouTube channel. I'll put a link to that in the bottom. These guys are really creative and cool, and you will like it. And if you don't, we can threaten them, right? It's a martial arts channel. You'll lose a sock in the next wash cycle. So watch yourself, pilgrim. Better do what we tell you to do. But seriously, these guys are going to help us out and show you what I mean by good focus mitt drills. You're going to notice that Ethan's going to use the mitt on his rear hand, not his front hand. And so he's going to keep his front hand lined up so he can smack his brother in the face when he's off position. Oftentimes when they're doing this live, he's bleeding and crying when he leaves. But seriously, you'll notice that the mitt holder is using good footwork, as well as a hitter. So it's not a one-dimensional drill where the mitt holder is just out there just standing around holding mitts. He's actually learning good spatial relationship skills at the same time, and he's in his ready position, ready to hit. So you're gonna check that out, and we're gonna show you a couple simple drills. So okay, now you'll notice in this one, so he's in his on guard position, so he's a mitt holder, but watch how he's working. He's stepping forward behind his straight punch. So he's not just standing here and doing nothing and being passive. He's actually working that straight punch. And watch, he's in a ready position, you know, as you saw. So when he shoots forward, he's going to respond to the motion. And so you're stepping forward, he's going back. And that's a great way to go. And then when the other thing going on for the mitt holder is that when you came back with your counter, he moved with him, so he's still hitting a moving target. This is training both parties to never stand still and start trading. Can't impress upon you guys enough how important it is to not trade. People get in trouble because they just stop moving, or they start moving in a way that's contradictory to the ready position and the JKD fundamentals. So again, watch him step forward, and you'll notice as you see the video of it, there's no telegraph to that windup. You know, and these guys are fantastic, and that groin kick is a brutal shot, and you'll notice how he can actually get back, and now the mitt holder is ready to fire as well. So if he doesn't recover properly, he's able to fire a groin kick, or he's able to fire a punch. In other words, if he does that to me and he steps forward, and I go back, and I come forward, but I kind of fall in, he's in position to hit me. That's a critical point of doing good liveness training with good focus mitts. Okay, so as you're going to notice with the other B-roll footage that you're going to see while I'm talking, instead of looking at my handsome mug. They're supposed to nod affirmatively for the camera. Thank you, guys. Don't check his YouTube channel out now. There you go. See what happens? But seriously, you'll notice that not only can you do a drill, that was more of like a closed drill, and you see other footage where they're working on fakes, they're working on going from long range into a pox out and hit. You can mix these up. We always try to keep them simple so that you're not adding too much stuff to it to make it right. You always want to fight the complexity dragon, if you will, because the more movements you get, if it's not simple, that means the other guy can do something, right? You can just move or counter. So if it's flashy, it's trashy. What we're looking to do is keep the fundamentals in play. And you'll notice they're faking, they're using hits to get back out. Both parties are using good footwork. This is a great asset to your training, and it's a great way for you to understand what real Jeet Kune Do footwork is under pressure, and so it develops the right habits. Because when you're sparring, a lot of people get into sparring too fast, and they're focused on their own technique and the other guy, and they just start taking damage, and that's not as effective for their overall growth. We want to be progressive, but you need to be safe. And so the goal is to outposition people, not get into firefights. So that's why good focus mitt training can help us get over that. Especially when you've got like young people here, you don't want them getting into, you know, a bashing fest where, you know, this is taking head trauma. You know, and moreover, I don't want to get kicked by this. I mean, you see their groin kicks. I mean, these guys can hit hard. And so the other aspect of it, even, you know, somebody who outweighs them, I outweigh both of these guys, and you know, I'm a grown man, and these guys take me down. So if you're in good position, you've got the tools, you can do it, but you've got to keep training for the position. And the mitt holder is going to be helping the hitter do that. And so therefore the mitt holder is getting good timing and accuracy with it. Okay. So, I think that's it. I mean, I don't really have any more bad jokes, but I told a bad joke last video. And I got nothing out of that one. So I was hoping I'd get more views out of my bad jokes, but, oh well. Anyway, like, okay, so ready? I'll give you one. What do you call a nun that sleepwalks? A Roman Catholic. Nothing. That's just this younger generation, man. I don't like the see-through dad jokes. Anyway, guys, thanks for coming. These guys are fantastic. We'll see these guys in a couple of videos later too. Don't forget to check out their channel. There's a link below. It's really good. I'm not in them for some reason. I don't know. They just didn't think I was worthy. But no, seriously. Thank you guys for being in here. These guys are great, and we'll catch you guys next time.